Hi everyone and welcome back. So we were writing a blog application and this is the part 3. Now we will be able to make some progress. This is going to be little lengthy, but we will try to see what else we can achieve. So this is the basic form we have created. I just added some controls by myself. Like here we have a local state, username, first name, password, and here we have handle change event. Okay, what handle change is doing is we will be able to call this handle change event from all the components. Here this is coming from the first name, last name, or username, right? Here we don't have a name property, so we can add a name property here. This is for username. And this is another name property will be for the first name. And this is for the last name. This is for the last name and this is for the first name. And why we are doing it? Because we want the key value pairs. First name, last name. Okay. So here we have created a first name, last name, username. Use in uppercase. Username. Okay. Now what we are doing is whenever we are going to write a single common method. So here from the event object, we can capture both the things, value and target. So name and value we are getting from what? From e.target. And here we can actually assign both the things together. This is my name and this is my value I'm getting. Okay, so this handle change can method can be reused for all the text fields. They will be updating their own properties, like first name will be updating first name, last name will be updating last name, and username will be updating username. Here you can bind it or you can write arrow function. It's your choice. We have already talked about these many times. There are many ways of writing it. I always prefer to write it with arrow function, but then you have to take care of passing it also while calling this function. Like here I need to pass it. Okay, now we have our last function. Now what we can do is handle change, remove the bind, pass the event object from here so we can access it. So we have three methods: handle change on the username, handle change on the password, and handle change on the last name. Okay, it should be event object and closing. Oh, it is complaining. Okay, now it is fine. Now we are using one common method to set username, first name, and last name. It is not password. Username, first name, last name. AL is caps, first name, last name. So we just need to take care that we are passing the right parameter in the value. So value here is a first name, value here is a last name. That is fine. First name, last name, username. Now if you just try to see this, event is not defined. Let's see this, where it is coming from. Okay, here it is. Now you see this particular form. Here we can just pass the first name, last name argument. And whenever you are doing on submit, we should be able to submit this, right? Now we just need to pass the event object and e.prevent default and stop propagation we have to do, so that we can prevent the form from the submission and we can do our own thing. Handle submit. Okay, e.prevent default. This is what we do. Or e.stop propagation. These two methods we can talk. Now we can just whatever the state we got, right? So what we can do is this dot props dot submit user. We can send this data to the parent user, parent component, this dot state. Okay, so we have a stop propagation and prevent default. This is what we are writing so that we can, we don't need to submit a form here, like simple HTML form. So stop propagation and prevent default. So prevent my user form submission. Now if I go there, Here first I need to pass the event object. Event object is being passed in the handle submit. We are using arrow functions, so we don't need to write anything. I will just anything. Now we should be able to submit it. Now this method is not defined, right? So we will just write this submit user in the parent component. Now we are able to achieve a lot from this component. This is our container component. So once user is created, we are actually calling this dot submit user. Here we actually getting the data that we are passing to this, and handle user is the method which is defined here. So we will be able to get the data which you are submitting through the form. So here we are getting the user. Now what we can do is we can create an Axios class where we will be submitting this form. So there can be a store. We can create a store, or you can say services, and in the services I will write axios.js. Here I will be writing class http service. Okay, here I can write all the methods get, put, post, delete. Okay, so till now we are in good shape. We are able to submit the, we are able to capture the data from the HTML form from this container. We are able to submit the form. We are passing both the arguments for username, first name, last name. Now we need to just make an API call to this HTTP endpoint, which we have shown in the APIs. Okay, and we will see what we are getting from there. Okay, thanks everyone.